Hey guys, it's me Nikki, and I wanted to do an update video about my whole journey with anxiety, losing my brother, these health issues that I've been facing all year. If you have been a part of my channel since last year, you know that I do every once in a while, I like to do a video where I am just talking about what I'm going through. It's a therapy for me, and I like to look back on my channel on these videos. Even if nobody else looks at them, I look back on them and I'm like, okay, I came out of that. I was in this situation then, and now I'm okay. If I can come out of that, I can come out of this. So these videos are more motivation for me and just looking at my growth and just what I've been through. And so last year in December, the day before New Year's Eve, my brother, who I was so close to, he was my best friend, passed away. And I was having a really healthy year last year. I lost 50 pounds. I was full of energy, and I don't know, I was at a good health area, my mental space, everything. And then that happened, and everything just went tumbling down. I started getting anxiety again, panic attacks daily, every day for 5 months. I had a panic attack. I gained the weight back. A lot of health issues have been flaring up. I was diagnosed with two more things this year, and it has to do with eating. I don't do drugs, I don't drink really. I really don't. I have like a glass of wine maybe 2-3 times a year, some dry red wine, but I turned to food. So I started turning to food as a comfort. It messed up my blood sugar levels. I'm not diabetic, but I have reactive hypoglycemia, so it's not diabetes, but I get a lot of low sugars, and I can just flare up in an ugliest way that puts me through a spiraling depression, and that happened. And I was just having panic attacks every day, freaking out, calling my husband, begging him to come home from work, and he'd have to, because I would be out of control. I couldn't settle down. I could not calm down, and it was the ugliest feeling, the ugliest time that I've had. And I couldn't call my brother. That's who I used to call. So it was kind of like getting used to life without him and getting over the shock that you're not here no more. And I was messing myself up by looking at old videos, hearing his voice, listening to old voice messages. And I had to stop that because I was going crazy. I was like, you know what? I'm going to lose it. I ended up in the hospital one time because I couldn't calm a panic attack down. It just, it wouldn't calm down. I ended up going to the hospital, and a doctor told me, life goes on. It sounds harsh, but people die every day. People lose their mothers. People lose their sons, daughters, and sometimes in the most horrific ways. And you still have to keep going. Life doesn't stop for nobody. You have to keep going, because if not, then your kids are going to be missing you, because you're going to hurt yourself. You're going to destroy yourself. You are destroying yourself. You're messing up any health issues you have. They're all flaring up. I was killing myself. So I was like, you know what? Okay. I came home. I was like, how do people get over this? I need to hear some testimonies, some stories. So I went on my Facebook, because that's where I'm more active. And I was like, I knew there was some people who had lost their brothers, but I was pleading for help. Nobody was reaching out. Nobody offered to talk to me or give me their testimony. So I was like, okay, maybe they just don't want to talk about it. So I turned to YouTube, and I ran into some people who were talking about death. And that's why I'm making this video, because the same way some people helped me by watching their video, I want to help somebody too, because it hurt when nobody wanted to be there. So you don't have to know me. You could have just randomly ran into this video. And I want you to know that it sounds harsh, but life keeps going, and you have to keep going with it. I had to quit listening to the voice messages. I had to stop looking at the pictures. I had to take every picture down. I had to do that. Not everyone has to do that. I had to do that. And I took all the pictures down. Any music that reminded me of him, I couldn't listen to anymore. I just kind of had to get used to the new life without you and figure out what else, you know, because when I say we were close, we were close. So I was like, okay, this is new life. This is how it is. I have a family. I have a husband and I have kids. I'm ruining my body. We got to get through this, because no matter how much I cry, hurt, he's not coming back. And this is the new reality. This is our new life. If you see the frame looking different, I'm sorry. I'm stopping the video sometimes because some people are coming in. They're doing some work at my house, and I have to stop the video to show them what needs to be done. But what I wanted to add to that is when I kept having the panic attacks every single day, I would have to call my husband to come home because I was freaking out. I would call friends, or I would try to call anyone else before I have to call him. And I want to say I have a friend who's always there for me, but she works two jobs, so she couldn't be attentive to me. Not that she needs to, but that's her personality. She likes to be there for me. But she was working a lot. And then I have another friend who would come every so often, but you know, no, there was nobody else to call. So I would call my husband and I'd be like, you know, I'm losing it. Like, I need you. And so he would come home. He was at a job where they were real understanding, and they would let him come home at any time. No questions asked. They're like, if you need to go, go. So we had that privilege at that job. So he would come home. The only thing is, yeah, he was here for me, and yeah, he came home and I had that support from him, but that was hurting the paycheck. So every single time he came home, he was missing hours, and guess what? Those hours add up and the checks were looking smaller. So now we're suffering financially, and that was just another stress added to what, you know, what was going on already. But I needed him so bad. I was willing to let go of things you don't even need, you know, like cable and Wi-Fi, like just things. We just had to just start letting things go because the support was more important. You know, I needed him so bad, and I'm like, just start letting things go. Just let it go, because I need help. You know, I need help. And then when you have agoraphobia, if you don't know what agoraphobia is, it's you get panic attacks every time you leave your house, or you don't feel like you're in your safe zone. It doesn't necessarily even have to be leaving your house. It can be just being in certain areas, certain wide open areas, stores, traffic, and you panic and you just can't function. You're just not going to be able to function. Your blood pressure is crazy. It's hard to bring it down until you feel safe again, or until you can get the panic attack under control. So my panic attacks are triggered by leaving the house. I feel like my home is my safe zone. So when I leave it, it's like all hell breaks loose. That's what it feels like. So that's agoraphobia. That means that I am 99% of my time of the year, I am home. I do get made fun of for that. People have made up the ugliest stories. It's just, it's weird, you know, knowing somebody who, wow, you never leave your home. But whenever I get my blood sugars under control and I'm feeling healthy, like when I told you I was in a good health space last year, I was in a good health space last year mentally and physically, I can leave the home because I feel healthy. I feel great. And then it makes me more outgoing, and I'm just like, okay, let's get out of here. And then I'll go to places like the grocery store, not too far, but I'll start to get out, go to the park, watch my kids play volleyball, have barbecues here and there. And, you know, I'm able to be more social. But this year, it's just, like I said, everything crumbled down. I was hiding in like a shell. And then I was reaching out to people. I would text anybody, could you come over here, you know, and spend time with me? Like, we can cook, we can do something together. You know, I got makeup, let's play with makeup, and nobody would show up, nobody would come. And that's just, if you are like that, who's watching this and you don't feel like you have anybody or any support, I feel you. Sometimes you don't have that support, and if you do have that support, you guys be so grateful for it. If you have a loving family or loving friends who are there for you, take care of them and cherish them. Don't ever take it for granted that you have that type of help, because some of us don't. I am blessed to have certain friends and, you know, just certain people. I'm thankful for that, you know, and to have my husband. But, you know, if you have that, be grateful for it. But this changed my life. It changed my health. It changed my mentality. It changed our finances. I was struggling from the most important areas, you know, except for my marriage. My marriage was, my husband has been there for me, and he's tried, and it hurts him to see me hurt. So that's the only part that our marriage struggled. He's like, I wish you didn't have these types of struggles. And I wish I didn't have these type of struggles either, you know? So my main focus now was my new normal. What is my new normal? How do I get over these crazy thoughts of I just lost you, life can end at any time, like just anxiety ridden thoughts? And I was like, you know what? It's time to just stop this. You're in control of your mind. You're in control of your life. And if it doesn't just change all at once, you have to take the steps to make it change. Even if they're small, a small step is still moving forward instead of just staying there or tumbling and spiraling down even further. So every small step, do not take that for granted. The smallest thing is the start to changing your life, changing your world, and changing your mind. And that's where it has to start. So I knew right then and there that this was going to be our new journey, and I had to just do the best that I could and keep pushing forward. And it's really hard because I lost my mom, my adopted mother. She was my grandmother, but she adopted me. And when I lost her, it hurt, and I went through a depression, and that's when I first like was getting panic attacks, agoraphobia, but it lasted about 6 months, and then I like, you know, continued. But like when my brother died, I think it hurt even more because he was a part of my life longer. My mother, who passed away, was only a part of my life till I was 18. And my brother passed away when I was 34. And he got to see my kids grow up. And he would help babysit. And he would spoil them. He was a part of my new life of being married, having a family. And I relied on him. And, you know, as far as calling him, we had health issues. No one understood the depression that comes with having like really bad health issues unless you have something going on yourself. So we can always relate to each other. There was no need to have to really explain. It's just a knowing, like, I know your pain and I'm here for you. So when I was down, he picked me up, and when he was down, I would pick him up. So it was like, now I don't have you no more. And then I got super sick. I just mean depression, anxiety. The anxiety was by far the worst. Yeah, I gained weight, but weight comes and goes. I've lost weight before many times. Weight can come and go. So, but the anxiety, I was like, something's got to give. The anxiety gets debilitating. It takes over your life. It ruins your life. If it turns into panic attacks and agoraphobia, and I struggled with agoraphobia. I didn't leave my house for 10 years, and then I broke free. Well, one time I didn't leave my house for 6 months. I broke free. I was free for 2 years, and then the agoraphobia came back even worse, and then I didn't leave the house for 10 years, and then I broke free for about, I want to say about 2 years, a year and a half, 2 years, and then it came back. When my brother passed away, it just came back full force. It's just been a hard journey. So what I want to give, and the positive message that I want to give on this video, is if you just lost somebody and you're like, the pain is so severe at this moment, just know this. And I know people hate when they hear this, time heals all wounds. I don't think it heals it completely, but it does something. It does do something. Time gives you time to get used to the new world, the new life. You know, time gives you time to heal in small areas of getting used to not having them for the first holidays, and just getting used to the fact that, okay, this is our new journey, this is our new life, this is our new normal. And time provides growth, time provides sadness as well, but overcoming little sadnesses of missing them on certain times of the day, certain times of the year, certain times of the months, and special holidays and birthdays. And in time, things start to come together little by little. So time does do something. So it's been a year, and I still can't hear the voice messages. I still can't look at the pictures, videos. I can't. Even sometimes talking about them, I break down and cry because I miss him so much. So the pain is still there. It's the first year. I know when my mom died, it took about 2 to 3 years to quit crying on that day that she died, you know. It was really hard. And like for my brother, it's just hard thinking that, you know, it's just still hard. But I am getting a lot better. I did have anxiety. I had full-blown panic attacks every single day for 5 months. And I was writing everything down because I like to write down my feelings. It's a therapy. Now this has become a new therapy since I'm on YouTube, talking about my feelings and then going back. So I love to write. I love to get it out. It has to come out. I can't keep those feelings and emotions stuck inside. I need to talk about it. I need to write about it. Not all the time, but there needs to be a time, like at least once a month, I make it a point to write down my feelings or talk about it. And I would make a video. I was making a video. I think I have a few videos on my channel where I'm just talking to the camera, either if it's about weight, health, or my brother passing. And it helps me. It's for me. But I was like, you know what? I want to give back. Watching those videos, testimonies of people who lost their sons and brothers and sisters and mothers and fathers, it helped me. And it gave me hope. And I'm like, wow, they went through it. And look at them. They're here today. They're smiling. They still miss them. But life continues. And it can still be beautiful. Life can still be beautiful. It'll be a different type of beautiful, but it can still be beautiful. And you just never forget the people that were in our lives. The people that we were blessed to grow up around. The people that we were blessed to be in a family with. Even if it's a friend. You know, blessed to call that person a friend, and you got to spend this time with remarkable people. Don't take it for granted. You know, make sure that you don't have any anger and hate inside of your body, inside of your heart. Because at any given moment, you just don't know what could happen. Everything can change in a blink of an eye, even for yourself. You can be feeling okay, and I've had this happen to me, and like that, you're fighting for your life, and that seriously has happened to me. So I just wanted to give an update, guys. I'm doing better concerning that. It still hurts. It still feels fresh. We're about to hit, you know, a year, but I'm doing a lot better. The last time I started having severe panic attacks, I want to say was in July. And then I've had battles with some new health issues, and having IBS now, and having lactose intolerance, and I'm allergic to something. I haven't figured out what food yet, but I've been trying to change some patterns that I was, you know, some really bad patterns that I had going on with food, and now that's getting better. So I need to take better care of myself for the year 2020. I'm going to focus on just being a better me, taking care of myself, and pushing forward. And about my YouTube channel, guys, it doesn't have a certain niche. People are like, what is your YouTube channel about? Is it cooking, DIYs, or are you just doing funny skits now? Like, what are you doing? And I'm like, you know what? I'm doing whatever makes me feel good. This year, YouTube has my journey with it. This channel means a lot to me. And I'm just doing whatever makes me feel good. If I feel like doing a DIY, I'm going to do a DIY. If my main thing is cooking, because I love to cook. So that's why you'll see more cooking on this channel. And now I just feel like being characters, like something inside of me wants to come out, and it's a therapy for me. Some of these skits are real life, things that have been told to me, me being made fun of because I wear makeup. Pancha, tia pancha. Y'all don't even know where tia pancha came from, but being pancha is actually helping me as well. So every single character means something to me. It's not just, oh, I'm just gonna do this to do it. No, it came from somewhere. It's supposed to be funny and make you laugh. It makes me laugh, it makes me happy, but these characters came from somewhere. So that's my YouTube channel, doing whatever makes me feel good at this. I mean, maybe later on there'll be a niche, like I'll make it into a channel that's only homemaking, because I am Nikki the homemaker. I am a homemaker. So everything homemaker, homemaking is cooking, cleaning, DIYs, making your house a home, making it feel like home, decorating. To me, that's a homemaker, just running the house. And then the funny skits and, you know, makeup. I think makeup too is homemaking, taking care of yourself. So when your husband comes in, or, you know, whoever you're with, is, you know, they get to appreciate, you know, you looking your best or wanting to be your best. So I don't know, but yeah, like the funny skits, maybe later on I'll do like a separate channel just for funny skits. But right now I'm just having fun with it. I don't know if I'm gonna continue with it. Maybe it's just something I feel like doing at this moment, but that's what I'm doing at this, that's what I'm doing with this channel. I am using this channel for therapy, and a lot of times I thought I was gonna lose my life with certain things that I go through. So I was like, I'm gonna leave recipes for my kids, so that way when they have their own kids, they can make foods, like stuff I wish my mom would have left me when she passed away, my grandmother. I like to call her mom. I wish I would have had some of her recipes so my kids could have tasted what I tasted growing up. So I'm leaving my kids recipes, and I'm trying new recipes, and they like the new recipes, especially the ones that I get from Steph from Views on the Road. They love them. So I just want to share that. So if something ever did happen to me, my kids have my channel and they can go back and look on it, and they can eat some of my foods, and they can show their kids what I used to make. God willing, I'll still be alive and I'll be able to cook for them myself. But you never know what could happen. So I wanted to leave a piece of me on this world. And I wanted to do it through YouTube. As one of the sources, I did want to do it through YouTube. So that's what this channel is about to me. And for all those that support me, I thank you guys so much. But we'll see how 2020 goes. I know I'm always going to miss my brother. And I'm going to miss a lot of other relatives too that I think of. But stuff happens, and maybe my kids will see this when they're grown up, when I pass away or something, and they can see that it does hurt when someone passes away, but you got to keep moving on, you got to keep pushing, and just appreciate the time that we did have on this earth together. You know, make the best of it, be positive, be love, spread kindness, you know, because why not? We're not here that long, so make it beautiful while you are. Anyways, thank you for stopping by my channel. If you haven't done so already, please hit that subscribe button. And if you would like more story times, or just, I guess, more motivational or tips, more things that I did through this journey or anything, and if I can provide you with some type of love or support, let me know in the comment section, and I will try to share it my best to my ability, share it with you guys, anything that's helped me. If you have panic attacks or anxiety, you need to talk, I'm here for you. I totally understand. A lot of people don't. I understand. I live it every single day. So God bless you guys, and I will see you on my next video.